Nice solid start. Legs are feeling real good. What is this guy doing? Should call this race the Hilly KOM after party. Oh yeah, feather. Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to Don't Get Drop Cycling, where I am tired of getting dropped. Sunday afternoon here. Jumped into a little chase race action. It's the Sunday Crash by Rhino Racing. I believe it's gonna be a modified lap of the big foothills. Not doing the whole thing, just 22.9K. So that's Fugle Flats, Titans Grove, and then just Hilly KOM. So again, I believe this is a chase race, so we should be working together for the most part. Until the end, where it's every man and woman for themselves. Especially up the hill at KOM, as far as I'm concerned. Alright. Let's continue our energy gel taste test. If you guys haven't seen the $100 unboxing of energy gels or any of the tests yet, links down there, up there. Somewhere. There's also a playlist on my channel as well, alright guys? So, let's pull the headband down and pick one today. I think I'm gonna go on this side. I don't know why, because I've been kind of getting things from over here. I just pulled it. What do I got? Alright, headband up. Put this thing back. What do we got? Ooh, trail butter. Original trail mix almond butter blend with sunflower kernels, chocolate dried cranberries, honey, and sea salt. That's very, very interesting. All right, guys, this is gonna be my first peanut butter, almond butter, whatever butter you wanna call it, type of energy gel, drink, food. They call this real food energy. Interesting. We got 200 calories, 8 grams of carbs, 4 grams of sugars, and 5 grams of protein. All right, let's just dive right into this and see what it tastes like. Ooh, I have a feeling it's gonna be like peanut butter. Wow, that's interesting. It's like really liquidy peanut butter. Like, it's not thick. It's like liquidy peanut butter with those sunflower kernels, chocolate dry crayons, honey, and sea salt. Like, you can taste them. Interesting. Again, you guys know fruit flavors are my number one. Peanut butter ones, I'm not gonna lie, it's not bad. I would definitely have it again. Would I go out on my way to buy it? Probably not, but if you're into peanut butter, that type of taste, again, keep in mind, the consistency is, it's not like SIS in your back pocket on a hot summer's day, like watery consistency, but it's not thick like regular peanut butter, if that makes sense. Very interesting. And you got like the sunflower, the chocolate, the dry crayons. You can like, you're like eating them. So it's like a gel, food gel. Not bad, guys. One thumb up. I'll give it 2 thumbs up. I mean, if you're into peanut butter, definitely give this a try. It's actually really good. And like, instead of just like a gel, which just kind of goes in and goes down, there's kind of like some food in it where you're chewing and it's almost like you're eating. So kind of changes it up once in a while, especially if you're out there on a long ride. you got a ton of gels. This guy changes it up a little bit. All right, in terms of where that fits in, SIS, still number one, by far. GU Energy, number two. Honestly, it's kind of a tie between Hammer Gel and Trail Butter. Right now, I've only tried one flavor of each brand. I'm definitely gonna put Trail Butter as my number three, Hammer Gel as my number four. Mainly because flavors and taste was a lot better from beginning to end on that Trail Butter. And then, like I said, a bunch of empty slots where we'll slide in a few other things. And then Huma. Huma Plus. Bottom of the basement. Like here and then further down. Alright guys, please like, subscribe, and hit that bell button. Leave some comments below in terms of the energy gel taste test. Have you tried Trail Butter? If you have, let me know if you liked it or not. And if not, was there a different peanut butter one that you liked? Let me know. And if you have an absolute favorite, which isn't part of my $100 unboxing, again, let me know. And I'll do my best to try to source some out for you guys, all right? Okay, it's almost showtime. Minute 20 left. Again, it looks like we're gonna work together today, guys. It sounds like everyone's gonna be trying to stick together to chase. So the goal is simple. Sit on everybody's wheels. Use as little watts as possible. Don't get dropped. And then take them all out at the finish line. All right. Ooh, by the way, guys. Been out twice now with my new Garmin Rally RK100 pedals. So cool to see the power data. Super duper 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 cool. I'm gonna definitely record something out there with those power pedals. And then do some overlays. It's gonna be nice. It's gonna be fun. Alright. Gotta get my music going. Uh-oh. Had my finger over that the whole time. Didn't press it though. Nice solid start. Awesome start. 3.7 watts per kg. Legs are feeling real good. Even after 100K yesterday morning at 5 a.m. That's right, boys and girls. 5 a.m. 100K rides are back. Went downtown yesterday to my favorite spot, looking back at the city, and then smashed home. I don't know if that vid is gonna be up before or after this vid, but if there's no link, check out my outdoor rides playlist or leave me a comment down below to add the link and I'll do it. Just trying to bring up Zwift power here. Alrighty. When am I gonna use this? Right now I'm thinking just before the tiny ramp before Titans, just help ease the pain a little bit. I don't know. If that's not the right time to use it, guys, let me know below. Only other time I can think of is if I don't pay attention and get dropped. I don't know if it's really worth using it while climbing. By the way, the first two rides with my power pedals have been so much fun. Almost spending too much time looking at the data. It's just cool to see the difference between inside and outside. After my first ride, I just wanted to hit 1,000 watts max. Second ride, after 100K, I hit this Strava segment behind my house and got 1,300. Honestly, I couldn't believe it at the beginning. I thought it was like not calibrated properly. But hey, not gonna be mad about that. Like I said though, I will make a video heading out there, doing some sprints and climbing some hills around Rattlesnake and the Niagara Escarpment. What is this guy doing? And honestly, guys, I'd be outside today, but it's windy. It's like 30 Ks, 40, 50 gusts. I just wish there was a little bit better race options available. I kind of want to do that zip classic. But unfortunately, it starts at 3 p.m.
don't think the wife is gonna be super happy if I'm still on the bike at 4:30. Cause the little man will be up from his nap already by then. And that's why I'm in this guy. Looks like we're gonna start catching some sea riders. Oh, I only got like 15 minutes of warm up, 10-15. This will warm you up. Hey, what happened to my arrow? Did I use it? What happened? I'm gonna have to review the film footage. I don't remember using it. And if I did, it was an accident. Oh well. Not gonna lie. Wasn't really gonna do much. Would have preferred a feather to get up Titans, or a draft maybe. Yeah, I mean, yes, it was better than nothing, but oh well. should call this race the Hilly KOM after party. I honestly didn't know you could take regular routes and shorten them. Pretty cool. Not gonna complain with the finish at the top. Alright, leaving Fugo Flats, on our way to Titan's Grove. Come on. Thank you. All right, last push, I think. Oh, maybe not. Oh yeah, feather. Thank you. All right, gotta recover as best as I can. Less than 3K before Hilly. Full gas to the top, guys, full gas. Oh my god. guys, oh, I'm reevaluating. Maybe I should have just went out in the headwind. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, guys. Oh, oh my God. Seriously. Oh, okay. That's it. Family time. The wife was already asking for me. 12 kilometers ago. Guys, please like, subscribe, hit the bell button below, leave some comments, and until next time, don't get dropped, alright? Take care, everybody.